This video is called Multiplying Polynomials 2. There are three different problems in this video. Make sure you watch the video and see all three problems and take notes for all three problems, as they're all just a little bit different and we want you to know how to do all three kinds. This first problem, we have a term, negative 6xy to the sixth. It's in parentheses, and it's raised to the power of 2. So basically, what this is saying is you take what's in the parentheses, the term, negative 6xy to the sixth, and multiply it by itself. So now, we have two polynomials. There's nothing in between the two parentheses, so I know it's multiplication. So just like what we've been working on, a negative 6 times a negative 6 is a positive 36. And then we will add our exponents. The x's, remember, if there's nothing there, it's really an exponent of 1. So x to the first times x to the first, you'll add those exponents and get x squared. Y to the 6 times y to the 6, you'll add those exponents and get y to the 12th. So you end up with 36 x squared y squared. Now let's look at the second example. This time we have a term, 6x to the 4th g squared, that's in parentheses and it's raised to the power of 5. So technically, we might have to write 6x to the 4th g squared 5 times. But I don't really want to do that, and because it takes a lot of room, there's a lot of paper, takes a lot of time. So we're going to work on a shortcut, where when you have a term raised to the power, it's called power to a power, and we can do some multiplication and some shortcuts. Please remember this 6 really has an exponent of 1. So what we're allowed to do, it's kind of like a distributive property, where this 5, the exponent on the outside, is going to multiply with every exponent on the inside. So we really have 6 to the 1 times 5, x to the 4 times 5, and g to the 2 times 5. Now this time we don't add the exponents, we multiply them, because when we have a power, an exponent raised to another power, another exponent, you actually multiply the exponents together. So we'll get 6 to the 5th, x to the 20th, and g to the 10th. The one thing I would do then to make this even better is 6 to the 5th is 7,776 x to the 20th, g to the 10th. One more, and this is going to combine a power to a power and then combining like terms as well. There's a lot going on in this problem. We have my first term, the negative 2x to the 3rd, y to the 4th, all raised to an exponent of 2. So that 2 is going to have to distribute with the 2, the x, and the y. And then in my second term, the 3x to the 5th raised to the 4th, that exponent of 4 is going to have to attach or multiply or distribute with everything in the second set of parentheses. So let's see what I get when I distribute or do the power to the power with the 2. So negative 2 is really negative 2 to the 1st. So I'm going to have to do the 1 times 2. X to the 3rd raised to the 2nd will be x to the 3 times 2, and y to the 4 times 2. So I end up with negative 2 squared, x to the 6th, y to the 8th. And now let's go ahead and do my second term, what I've been outlining in green, the power to the power. This time the exponent is a 4, so I will do 3 to the 4th and x to the 5 times 4. So I have 3 to the 4th, x to the 20th. Now I have to combine all the like terms that I have. In one big multiplication problem like this, let's see. I've got negative 2 squared, which is a negative 4, x to the 6th, y to the 8th, 3 to the 4th. Let's clean that up a little bit. 3 to the 4th is 81, and x to the 20th. Well, the like terms I have would be the negative 4 and the 81, which gives me a negative 324. And then let's see, I have an x to the 6th and a y to the 20th, so that will be x to the 26th, and then the y to the 8th is left over by itself. So it started as a power to a power where I multiplied my exponents together. And then when it came time, it was just big one big multiplication problem and I wanted to combine some like terms with these x's. It's not a power to a power anymore. So you would add the exponents and get 6 plus 20, which is 26. So be careful. When you have an exponent raised to an exponent, that's when the exponents multiply. But when you're just combining like terms and multiplying down here, the 6 and 20 you end up adding.